Hey everyone, Eric with Upton Base here, and I'm just going to do a quick little video about bridge position. I know Gary did a video when he went way into detail, and you should definitely check that one out, but I wanted to just do like a little quick one, almost the little speech that I give to people when they walk on the showroom floor, because your bridge should last a very long time. Now, this notion of a bridge lasting 5 to 10 years and then needing to get replaced, that's your fault. Really, no nice way to put that. This bridge can last a very, very long time if you take some very simple maintenance tips. And you should watch that video Gary did. That shows you exactly how to put things, knock things around. But I wanted to just give this quick one. Your bridge is basically, think of it in three different positions. Like, you know, when you're in school in the graph charts, you know, you have an X, Y, and a Z. So basically, if you take a north-south position, you can tell where the bridge is supposed to be because the luthier told you. The luthier put these little notches here, and if you drew a line from notch to notch across the base, that line should bisect the middle of the bridge foot. So if you're looking at the bridge from the side and that line bisects the bridge foot, you know that north-south, you're in a good position. The other one's gonna be east-west. Okay. And you can do that, just basically grab your base, sight down like it's a rifle, and you can see it. I mean, if it's out of whack, you'll know within 2 seconds of looking down the fingerboard, the bridge is one way or the other. So you can reposition your bridge based on an east-west. So if east, west, north, south are all good, we got one position left, and that's gonna be how much it's leaning. Are you leaning towards the fingerboard, which is more likely, or are you leaning away towards the tailpiece, which is kind of unlikely, because every time you tune the strings, you're dragging these strings and you're bringing them up into the peg box. The windings of the strings embed themselves with the fibers of the wood, and as much as every luthier can try to put as much graphite, pencil lead, whatever in here to make it slip over the top, it doesn't always work that way. So what happens is, as you tune the strings, you're bringing this bridge incrementally up towards the fingerboard. It's your job to push it back. Okay. We got a couple different techniques that we've showed. Gary's got one, that in-depth video. Definitely check that out. But if you put your bridge back, and we have a bridge stick too that we provide with Upton bases, so you can check that. But if you put your bridge back, so it's not leaning forward, that bridge will stay nice and stable. So east, west, north, south, and then we have yaw, Z, whatever position you want to call it, how much the bridge is leaning. If you check those three things, let's say once a month, let's say on the first day of every month, if you just do that one thing, you'll save yourself 500 and something bucks, because that's what most shops are charging now for bridge width adjusters. So if you do that one thing, you'll save yourself money, you'll have better intonation and more enjoyment out of your instrument. All right, rant over. Have a good day.
Gary said it should be perpendicular to the top. I don't know what to do. All right, let's make it simple.